Hey guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can write and execute a Java program using Notepad and command prompt. Now, in order to continue with this video, you have to download and install Java JDK in your computer. If Java is installed in your computer, then you can go ahead and follow the steps that we are going to do here. So now, what we do is we will create a folder in the desktop. You guys can create the folder wherever you want. I will call this folder as Java. Now inside this folder, what I will do is I will create a simple Java file, and then we will see how we can run that. Now the next thing that we do is we will open up any text editor. We will open up the Notepad, and once the Notepad is opened, we can save this file. So we will click on this file, and then we will click on save. Now we will go to the desktop and we will open up the Java folder that we have created moments ago. And in this folder, we will save our Java source file. I will call this file as hello.java. And here, save as type, make sure that all files is selected. Otherwise, it will be a text file, okay? The files which contain the Java source code will have the .java extension. After that, we will click on this save. So now the file has been saved. What we can do is we can write a very simple Java program. So let us say package, and let us give a name for the package. Let us say demo. And after that, we will create a class. I will increase the font size here. Since the name of the file is hello.java, we will create a class with the name hello. So it will be class hello. And then in this class, we will have the static void main method, which will be the entry point of our program. So it will be public static void main. And then this main method will take a string array as the parameter. So it will be string array, and we call these parameters as args. And then what we want to do in this main method, for the demonstration purpose, let's simply print out hello world or hello YouTube text to the screen. So it will be system.out.println, and here we will have the text hello YouTube. Okay, after that we will go to file and we will save the program. So now we will close this text editor. We will go to the folder where we have saved our program. In this case, hello.java, which is present in this Java folder, which is present in the desktop. Now, how we can run this file? In Java, first what we have to do is we have to compile the source file, and we have to generate a file which will contain the bytecode, and then we have to provide that file which is containing the bytecode to Java interpreter, and the Java interpreter will run the program. So here what we do is we will open up the command prompt with this particular path. So I will go to this navigation section. I will left click in my mouse here in this empty area, and then I will type in cmd and I will hit the enter button. It will open up the command prompt in this particular location. So you guys can see desktop Java. So now what we do is we will use the Java compiler and we will compile this hello.java. So it will be javac. Javac is the Java compiler. And since our source file contains the package information, we have to use -d flag here in order to say that when the dot class files are created for every class that is present in the source file, place those class files inside the folders with the name of the package. If it is confusing, don't worry. What we are doing is, in the program, we had the package name as demo. So the class hello is present inside the package demo. And that's why when we use this -d here, what it does is it will create a folder with the package name, which is demo, and inside that folder we will have the dot class file for the hello class. Okay, So here the next thing is where we want to save the generated class files. We want to save them in this current folder from which we are running this command. So I will specify dot here, and then we have to provide the name of the file. So in this case it is hello.java. Now if I hit the enter button, nothing happens in the command prompt, but if you look at the folder here, a new folder has been created with the name demo. If you remember, the package name that we have given is demo. Now if I open up this demo folder, we can find this hello.class file, which contains the bytecode for the hello class. So when we compile the Java source file, what happens is for every class that is present in the source code, a class file will be created. So now we will go back to the Java folder here. Now in order to run this program, what we have to do is we have to provide the name of the class which is containing the entry point of our program, which is the static void main method. So here we have to call the Java interpreter by using Java, and then we have to provide the name of the file or name of the class which contains the static void main method. But in our example, the hello class which contains the static void main method is present inside the demo package, and that's why we have to type in demo dot name of the class which is hello, just like this. And after that, if I hit the enter button, as you guys can see, we get hello YouTube, which is the output of our program. So this is it guys, a simple way to write and execute a Java program from Notepad. I hope you guys, you know, write this and try to execute so that you can have the understanding of how things work out. So this is it guys, thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, subscribe to the channel.